buns and 10-cent red roses from department store counters, watching the moonlight reflect off the river, beside where the trains cross the bridge and slow down. Trains with white letters and black iron sides, and wild rushing water that all rolls away. And little Miss Someone does not want to stay. Everyone's moving with places to go, and Mr. Zero, he sadly stands still. As the water goes one way, the train goes another. Mr. Zero stands still and Miss Someone don't bother. The present moves out on the sunset's crescendo, as seagulls of dawn set their wings to the air and fly without resting on outward bound breezes, to die where horizons are melting the dusk. The eyes of the summer are closing forever. The earth takes a breath to prepare for the fall, and little Miss Someone won't pay for the call. The hand of the autumn undresses the trees. Mr. Zero says, please help me up off my knees. Miss Someone is speaking, the world will believe her. Mr. Zero just nods and hangs up the receiver. This will be cold by tomorrow, as campfires of midnight dissolve in the darkness. The room is deserted, the blinds have been drawn. Little Miss Someone is packed up and gone. Fast moving cars disappear down the highway, with signs that say, hitchhikers do not disturb. Mr. Zero looks quietly up from the curb. Morning has faded and shadows have grown. Little Miss Someone is on her way home. Mr. Zero stands watching, her plane flies above, and with frostbitten hands waves goodbye to his love. Oh, walks through the park on a bright summer Sunday, and tapestry kittens that hung on the wall, they all die in the air like a soft minor chord, a vacancy sign and a bulletin board. Mr. Zero is wrapping his jacket around him, speaking kind words that should have been said long ago. But little Miss Someone does not want to know. The night is deserted, there's dust on the shelf. Mr. Zero sits lonely and talks to himself. It's too late to change, the fine line has been crossed. The charades are all done, Mr. Zero has lost.
Mermaid on the sand, reaching out with helpless hands for someone to understand. Sometimes I get to thinking of the way she used to cry. It makes me want to rise and picture on the sky, so everyone would see how sadly beautiful she is, and bring sunshine to the darkness where she lives. Dayland is a bird with frozen wings. She's the queen of everything that's been forgotten by the spring. She has been deserted by song that no one hears, holding memories like a mirror, reflecting images of tears. All her faithless vagabonds have finished with their scenes. She remains discarded in graveyard of her dream. Whenever I see Moses helpless in the rain, my thoughts go turning back to Dayland.
The thunder cracks against the night. The dark explodes with yellow light. The railroad sign is flashing bright. The people stare, but I don't care. My flesh is cold against my bone, and Cheryl's going home. Come hear me shouting through the rain. Is there a way to stop the train? I've got some reasons to explain about the way I was today. The whistle moans and I'm alone, and Cheryl's going home. Santa Rosa special down the line. I'm running desperately behind. There's only one thing on my mind. The rain and tears are in my eyes. The things I have to say will not be known, and Cheryl's going home. And Cheryl's going home.